3D Funny Chicken Acrylic Nail Art Tutorial by Hotpinkzebrapolish.
Hi guys, in today's video I'm going to show you part 2 of my funny farm animal series, and this one is going to be the chicken. And all of these videos, all 3, have a Melody Minutes at the end, so if you want to see a little bit of this goon and what she does on the daily basis, except for today, because it's been a meltdown day for us, but normally she's a pretty happy little girl. There are videos at the end of each of these, so check for those, and I'll see you next time. Bye!
To begin with, we're going to start with an overlay of grass green acrylic. I did the same color background for all 3 of these nails. If you weren't doing all 3 of them, you wouldn't have to do the same color for each one. If you're just gonna do a chicken, then you can, you can still do grass green. It does seem appropriate still. But then we're going to encase the nail with a layer of clear acrylic to make sure it is nice and strong, and then file the nail into shape with an e-file. If you don't have an e-file, a hand file is fine. I get that question here and there. And using a hand file is no problem. If you watch my older videos, you can see that for a long time I was a hand file girl. But now that I have an e-file, it's kind of like a you can never go back sort of thing. So I'm going to now start sculpting my chicken, and I'm going to begin with an off-white color. So you don't want like a really bright stark white. It's just a little too harsh for this kind of a cute, funny type of a design. And to me, in this case, I think that a full white chicken would look unfinished, like he didn't, like he needed something. So then I'm going to be adding his comb with red. And the other thing is, if you use an off-white color, then you can go through and you can add bright white eyes, and it makes his eyes pop a little bit more, which is always a nice detail. So just take that red acrylic and add the comb. And you can detail the comb and add some texture and depth to it if you'd like, or you can keep it pretty simple and cutesy as well. And with that off-white, you're still going to want to add just little bases for his legs. And then I'm going to do one eyeball before I do the other one. I'm just going to let that set up. I'm going to move on and sculpt a wing. So there's the first little wing, a little bit of texture on it, kind of tuck in the acrylic of the eye that was starting to spread out a little farther than I wanted, and then add the second one. The reason that I didn't do both of them at the same time is because they would have just blended together and created one morphed large eyeball instead of 2 separate distinct eyeballs. Add the little bit of tail feathers, the other wing, and then add his wattle, just like that, 2 tiny little petal shapes. And then moving on to a yellow color, we're going to be adding his feet. So there's the one. And my yellow is not very pigmented, as you can see, so it doesn't show up very well. But we can fix anything like that later with acrylic paint. You just need to get that base shape sculpted. So anytime you have a color of acrylic for a design that you need and do not have, as long as you find something close, like say you really need a certain shade of brown but you don't have that exact one that's for something specific, sculpt with whatever you have, and then you can adjust it later with just paint or gel polish. Gel polish is not probably ideal, but gel paint or acrylic paint work fantastic. So we're going to be brightening up our chicken with the chicken's comb and wattle with a brighter shade of red acrylic, and then with a brighter shade of yellow acrylic paint, sorry, not just acrylic, but acrylic paint, we're going to be, like I said, adding some more brightness to beak and feet. And the feet are kind of like a Y shape, so there's the 2 toes on top and then the long heel that comes down. And then with slightly diluted black paint, I'm going to go through and I'm going to add all of the details to my chicken. And if you guys are wondering why I said gel polish isn't ideal for adding details and an abundance of color to a design, the reason for that is that it's thicker. So gel paint, when you're painting with it, you spread it on very, very thin. So it doesn't add much thickness or depth to the nail, and it won't flood details. So a gel polish, in essence, the goal of a gel polish is to smooth out the nail plate and make it look really plump and really nice and healthy, and get rid of any ridges or bumps that may be there. So if you are sculpting something and you're sculpting in details and ridges and bumps, you don't want the product you put on top of it to smooth out all of that work. So the reason for gel polish is not the same, or the purpose of gel polish is not the same purpose for adding color to something 3D. So that's why a gel paint or acrylic paint that are very thin and pigment packed are a better route to go. So I'm going to go through, add the rest of the details to my little chicken, and then I'm going to add some gel sealer over the background to make that grass really shiny, and then some matte top coat over Sir Chicken. And that's it. If you missed the cow, I'll put a link for him in the description box below, and then tomorrow there'll be the pig.
Hey Melody, on a scale of 1 to 10, how cute are you?
Cool.
two. No, say 10.
10.
Okay, let's try it again. On a scale of 1 to 10, how cute are you?
2.
No, say 10.
10.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
Mom, I think I'm the driver.
Thank you guys so much for watching. That was Melody and her favorite cousin, so they're best buds. I hope you guys like this video, and don't forget to share any recreations with me. Bye!